Alright guys, welcome back to another vlog. So today I'm driving this, the Volkswagen Passat. It's a 7th generation Volkswagen Passat. Now let's give a quick walk around of this car. Now let's move on. So here we have a Volkswagen badging, a little bit of chrome treatment over here, as you can see this one. And yeah guys, you even get the projector headlamps over here, and you get a headlamp washer over here, and the LEDs are, it's not an LED but it's an indicator of spin, and you get a cornering for fog lamps over here. It's pretty decent to the, by the way, clearance. Now let's talk about the ground clearance of the vehicle. The ground clearance of the vehicle is somewhere around 113 mm, so I would prefer that. It's a kind of low car, so let's begin. Let's move on the side profile of this car. So the side profile is somewhere around this type of view, which comes with an Audi A4. So the side profile is like completely massive long length. The comparison of this one would be made by Skoda Superb or the Toyota Camrys. So now I would say that I like the way the lines are in till the tail lamp, and you get a chrome treatment over here, a bit of chrome treatment and all those things. No passive entry, all obviously. This is a 2009 variant. Now let's move on to the back thing. Now I'm gonna open. Now how to open? Now that let's go on the side, back profile of this vehicle. The back profile of this vehicle is literally, I love the rear light which I've been, this has been really admiring me a lot guys. And there's a 2-liter TDI engine written over here. You get a Passat written over here, Volkswagen badging over here. So this is what it is from the side back profile. So I really love that. And we're now opening the trunk space of this vehicle. Let's open this one in this way. So the trunk space is actually humongous guys. You can see that this is actually 567 liters of boot space. That's pretty good actually, not even pretty good, it's pretty high actually. So now let's move on to the alloy. The spare wheel is an alloy, so definitely you get an alloy in this at this price point. And the newer version you would be costing somewhere around 28 lakhs. So this car is obviously on the sale guys in Chitra Cars. So this car is around 6 lakhs. I mean, you can, it can be negotiable on the Now the tire size is 215 by 55 R16 tires, and this is an Apollo tires. By the way, these are low profile tires, so that you can see that the tires are a bit flat over there, and you get a dual tip exhaust over here, even in this side, and the same on the other side. So now let's move on to the interior. Alright guys, now let's move on to the interior first. So there's a center armrest over here. It's pretty decent over there, and you can even access the boot from the rear seats. So I'm gonna show you this one. Actually, it is pretty locked actually. So I'm gonna open it other side. So yeah guys, you get a twin two cup holders over here, and you can close it in this way. The underside support is pretty good, I say. The legroom is on offer, is like pretty much high enough to sit a passenger, and the recline position is absolutely fine, so that it's like, it feels like an A4 or A6 variant. And the scooped out seat back, and you get a magazine holder over here, AC vents over here, you can adjust the AC vents, and you can even get a 12 volt charging socket over here. And so you can get a sun visor over here guys, you can even get the sun visor over here, and you get a ashtray over here. Now this is a specific variant over here. So this car might be, as it is a German car, German build quality is pretty much fine, absolutely. So you get an ashtray over here, all this, the Germans used to get cigar over here, so that kind of thing. So let's close. So the recline angle is pretty good of this vehicle, and you can absolutely sit in here. And you get a 3 headrests over here. Obviously 3 people can sit here, but the only major thing is like you get a bump over here. So the middle person might be feeling a bit difficulty. So it is what it is about the rear seats. Now let's move on to the front seats guys. Now let's move on to driver's seat guys. So driver's seat actually gets pretty good actually. Electrical adjustment features over there seat. So this is a height adjuster. You can, increase the height of the vehicle, and you can even decrease the height of the vehicle, as you can see that. Now this is the front and back, and this is for the reclining position of the vehicle. And this is the massager guys. This is the massager feature where you can get actually a massager in this pretty car, and you get a 3 memory seats. Now let's move on to the door guys. You get a 1 litre bottle holder over here, and you get some stuff to store space over here. So you get a handlebar, and you get a handlebar, and these are for the adjustment of the mirrors, and these are the power windows of this one obviously, and this is the trunk, and this is the fuel lid. So let's move on to the interior now. Yep, now let's move on to the dashboard of this vehicle. Dashboard comes with a headlight leveler. This is the headlight leveler of this train, and this is the parking sensors over there, and that's it guys. This is to unlock and unlock this vehicle. So now let's move on to the dashboard of this vehicle guys. So that the dashboard gets pretty much racing. This is a tachometer over here, and you get a temperature meter over here. Let's come to the front. So this is a tachometer over here, this is a temperature meter over here, this is a fuel gauge, and you get a speedometer over here, and this is the door is open actually, so that's what it is indicating. And on the steering side you get an indicator on the left side over here, and you get a windshield wipers of the right side, so that this, and you get even a cruise control over here, and volume increasing, volume down, muting the phone, everything is done over there, and it's pretty basic though. So you get, this is a top end variant, so you can get all these features over here. And yep guys, the audio system in this car is pretty good actually. This is a Harmony audio system, which is from the JBL. So alright guys, now let's move on to the audio system. The audio system is pretty good actually. You know, the bass quality is pretty much high. So hopefully you can hear that one. And that is what about the audio system about it. Let's mute it quickly. And yep, let's mute the audio system. And now let's talk on the transmission over here. By the way, this is an automatic transmission. So you have a gear selectors over here. Just park in park mode, reverse. And you get a reverse. There's no mirror over here, so that it's a problem over there. And now get into the driver selector, drive mode is even manual. Just press the manual button over there, and you can even turn into the sport mode over here. Yep guys, you get all the parking mode, reverse mode, neutral, and this is the neutral. Just this is a drive selector and this is a sport mode. So it is what it is about the car. And you get a parking asset is here. ESP is off, I mean the So now that you get the ESP is off, the traction control is there and parking assist over there, and all the things are pretty decent over here. And you get electric handbrake over there, and the glove box is pretty decent. You get an aux port inside, so that aux is available over here, and you can stuff some. This is by the way cooling feature guys. There's a refrigerator inside. So yeah, you get two cup holders over here, and these are pretty decent, like 1 liter cup holders. And this is the button for just closing this one, and that is what it is. And you get a dual zone climate control over here. Heating seats are available, and even the massager is there in this seat in this vehicle. Like, it is a premium luxury car, a mid-sized premium luxury car, which would be comparable around like Toyota Carmi or also like Skoda Superb. So now let's move on to the dashboard. The piano finishing, or the wooden finishing over here, is pretty decent, and it has come 8 airbags with it. So there are 8 airbags. This is the one, and you can see always airbag detent over here, and airbag detent over here. Even in the driver side, the steering wheel, back, even the airbags are there. So you get, holders over here. And now coming to the roof of this vehicle. So roof of this vehicle, you get a sunglass holder over here. So this is a sunglass holder, and this is for the opening of the roof. Okay, sunroof. So it's automatic guys, by the way. You can check the sunroof is open now. And by the way, auto dimming in this vehicle isn't there available, but of course you can provide. This vehicle has been providing the better view of this rear view mirrors. You get a light over here, light placement over here. Of course light is working. And now let's move on to this one. You get a light placement over here, and light and mirror obviously you need to get at this price point. And same on the other side though, you get a mirror with a light placement over there. Obviously at this point where you need to expect that one. Now the sunroof is pretty decent. Now it's half the way out, and now let's move on to the again of this one. Let's close this one sunroof. Yep, it's completely off guys. The airy feeling of this vehicle is pretty decent, and I would say that it's like huge, and you feel like the cabin is feeling like completely airy in this vehicle. And yep, that is what it is. And the seat positions are pretty decent, I would say, because like under thigh support is a bit laggy, I would say. But reclinability of this vehicle and height adjustments and the massages are absolutely phenomenal. Now let's get into the driving test. I know that most of the people are waiting for that one itself. So let's, without any further ado, let's get to the driving. Peace. Alright guys, so let's get driving to this vehicle. So this vehicle has been launched this is the 7th generation Toyota, Volkswagen Passat. So by the way guys, the Honda has been launched its rivals to the Volkswagen Passat, which is the Honda Accord. Obviously Honda Accord has been increasing its sales units though. So, and by the way, it is the 7-speed DSG gearbox. I really appreciate it, because it's the variant of this car is like 2009, but still even though the newer variants even get this 6-7-speed or 6-speed DSG gearbox over here. Alright guys, now let's move on to the vehicle information. So this vehicle has been coming with a variant of this is the top end variant guys, by the way. So this vehicle comes with a DSG class gearbox, 6-7-speed DSG class gearbox. And by the way, the Indian cc of this vehicle is 1968 cc, which is pretty cool I would say. And the fuel economy is pretty much lower than the compared to the regular cars. Obviously that might be the thing, because this is a mid-size luxury car. So I would definitely say this is a luxury car, because like you get a massager over here in the seats, and the seats are pretty comfortable I would say, because like the seats literally hug you over, and because like the bucket seats in the seats, cornering it might be the pretty good car, which might be supporting the corners pretty well. And I would say that overall this car, I definitely prefer this car. So now let's move on to the specifications of this car. This car comes with a 1968 engine, which produces around 350 Nm of torque, and redlines at 6000 RPM guys. Literally redlines at 6000 RPM, it's another level. So yeah, and by the way, the car has been discontinued in the year 2013. So the newer generation, by the way, the Camry, the Toyota Camry, and the even Skoda Superb are still going on in the market. The highest selling number of units. So this car has been even thinking to relaunch in this year, the 2018 model, the 2020 model, the Volkswagen Passat. Feel about this car?
The car is pretty amazing. I love driving this car.
Okay.
And now I'm selling this car.
Alright. So at what price are you selling this car?
I'm selling this car at 6 lakhs.
Alright, that's pretty good price actually. So what's the variant of this car? I mean model of this car?
This is 2009 model.
Alright. How many kilometers it is run?
73,000 kilometers.
Guys, it's literally amazing. 73,000 kilometers run, and it's a 2009 variant though. So this car comes with everything fully loaded features, guys. So cornerings in this car isn't an issue, guys. The seats literally hug you completely, so that the cornerings will be never an issue of this car. I love the way the bucket seats are there, so you can really feel the corners and you don't even go roll out of the seat. So that's kind of pretty good actually in this car.